big pod, big pod.
Yes, sir, dude. I'm loading up.
Dude, we might want to lift anchor. I'm not joking, bro.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Really quickly, I just want to show you the setup that we're running out here, and then after that, I'm going to give you a couple tips that we're finding to help us out here on the lake. First things first, I've got a high-capacity reel. I'm running a Stradic. It is a 4000 series, so it has a lot of line capacity. And for our rod, I have a Fenwick HMX. It is a 12 to 25 pound, 8.6 medium heavy. You really want to make sure that you have a fast tip on your rod. For our mainline, I'm just running 30-pound Power Pro right here. And I am tying I think it's an Albright knot to a 16 pound fluorocarbon leader that is about, I don't know, I'd say about 4.5, 5 feet long, right down to a P-line jigging spoon. Some people like running monofilament for their leaders. I've been trying it out. Some of the lighter monos have the same line diameter as some of the higher pound test fluorocarbons. For example, 12 pound monofilament is about the equivalent of 16 pound fluoro. I've tried running it before. The mono's nice because you get a little bit of a stretch in your leader for like random runs and hard head shakes, but I am finding that I am getting more on the fluorocarbon for sure. You really can't go wrong with this. I wouldn't go over about a 10-foot rod, but it's really important that you guys have a fast tip and a lot of line capacity.
What the heck?
I thought I was gonna run when I ran.
Hey, all right. All right, that's
I've
it.
I've never seen a deer that tame at this in my
life. I love it.
That has to be some form of good luck. I've never had a deer in the wild just come up and lick my hands before, but I gave it a little piece of a pickle and I won him over. So hopefully the deer are biting, the fish are biting, so.
Oh, there's one.
Jump for the anchor here, right?
He's in the anchor here. Dude, there's a hot fish.
I was sleeping, dude. I was about to fall asleep.
It looked like a really nice fish. Dude, where's the net? Okay, we got it. Okay.
We got the net, don't worry. I brought it this time.
It's a decent one.
It's got a lamprey on it, I think.
It does.
Maybe. I don't know, that'd be pretty cool.
It's not huge.
That dude, that's a
better fish than we caught, dude.
Oh yeah, look at the way he's flying. It's chrome. Leader, leader, leader. Dude.
Oh my gosh.
Marking some of his friends down there. He don't like that net. Dude, I hate that. Just hate that hook. Oh, and the hook just popped out.
Nice, man. Just finally got a solid fish in the boat. Still pretty early in the morning here. Nice wild fish, tall dorsal fin, nice adipose. Took the black Luna jig spoon. They get a little bigger than this, that's for sure, but I can't complain. We got a fresh fish and great fight, and I'm sure it's gonna release really well here. Give me all those tail pops, you. Down, straight, vertical, baby. Let's go.
Let's go.
Have you ever talked before this?
A little bit, not too much.
There's one. Yep. Oh yeah. It hooked right. Can't tell if it feels big yet. It's a lot of head shakes, dude. What is this? I don't even know if this is salmon, dude. Oh yeah. Yeah. Look at that graph, dude. Get a shot of the graph on my camera.
That fish came up. You can see him chase it. Absolutely smoked it. And we're tight. How's it feel, man? Yeah, I got them both out.
Dude, we might want to lift anchor. I'm not joking, bro.
I need turtle.
Try. No. Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Really good fish, dude.
Yes, that's the one. That's the one.
Oh yeah, dude. Dude, it popped the hook out.
Wait, no, it's big.
Oh, okay. I saw the swivel out front. Freaking smacked it. Oh yeah, freaking brute right there, man. Nice hen. Dude, all right.
There's a couple main little tips I wanted to point out to you guys, some things that we've been finding helpful. First things first, dead sticking. I'm not really sure what it is, but it seems like when we're really just freaking popping our jigs up, it seems to be scaring away a lot of fish, but we've noticed when we leave our lines laying out of the side of the boat that it's actually bringing some fish in. And if you can lure some fish in and you have a graph and you can visibly see that there are fish coming in towards your lure, you should be able to mark your lure on a fish finder like this. If you see fish coming up to it, kind of start baby tapping it, kind of make it seem like it's inching away. We found that we've been getting some hookups like that. Second thing for us, any spoons underneath a 2 ounce jigging spoon, we just are not getting the action out of it, and we are definitely not getting hookups on 1 ounce, half ounce, stuff like that. Might work in some shallower water, but these 2 ounce jigging spoons, I'm using these P lines right here. They've by far been our best ticket. And then, what was the last thing we were going to talk about? We talked about the dead sticking, we talked about fluoro, we talked about... Oh, yes, line sensitivity. So one of the good things about running braid, you can run mono doing this, and it's nice because it has stretch. But one of the nice things about braid is that it does not have a lot of stretch. You're very sensitive. So if you feel any bites, especially jigging, you're going to feel the most faint bites. What we're finding is when we're jigging, when you're popping it up, don't let your line go slack and pull your lure down to the bottom. You really want to make sure that you have some sort of sensitivity with your rod tip, keeping tension with your leader, so then you can detect the bites. Because I'd say about 90% of the bites that we are getting are on the fall when our spoon is fluttering down. That's about 90% of the time when your fish are going to hit. So if you have some sort of tension on your way down, but you want to have it taut so then you can feel any sort of slack in your line, any sort of ticks, set the hook and reel in on that. So as far as tips, that's what I'd give you guys. I hope that helped you guys out.
You gotta get a mag, dude.
Should I? Dude, you got fish all over you, bro.
Dude, yeah, I just think we're on a pot of fish.
Got one? Got one. Here, should I? I'm gonna double. Let's go, Owen. Oh, that's a nice one.
Turner. Oh, you got her all three. You're good. Let's go, Owen. That's a straight Cromer. Push down on our tail and lift up. Yeah. Yep. Nice.
Yeah, the cones in the back.
Dude, parking that ship, dude, I could never. There you go.
You got him, Brock? Reel down.
Oh,
no, you got him, Here you go.
Let's go.
Down to the right. Here, run down here. Let's go.
I got him this time.
Let's go.
How's it look? Just so I can see.
Looks money.
Really?
I just got a big crank down on it.
No, that's good. That's good. You're good. Don't touch it.
Run back here. Dude, he's getting freaking torqued right now. Just pull straight off. Take it. First time on the jigging spoon here for Mr. Brock here. Brock, how old are you?
11 years old, dude, and he's cracking them.
He's the first mate for a charter boat. 11 years old, man. He's next up, baby.
Whoa! Let's go, baby.
Here, get down, Brock. I'll get a picture with you and I. Mr. Brock, man.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Let's go, dude. Let's go, Brock.
That is sick, dude. Go.
All by himself, man.
Gotta send it to Hunter, too.
Your first jigging king, how was it, man?
Awesome.
Everything you hoped and dreamed of?
Gotta brag to Hunter because it's on his setup.
Yeah, Hunter. Go, dude. Going on Hunter's setup.
That's good. We got 4% left, dude. Dude, this place is a gem.
How, good, bro.
How'd the trip go, Owen?
Dude, tiring, but we bopped him, man.
Kinda. I mean, dude, like, it was give or take. Sometimes it was baller. And,
oh, we had to work for our fish, dude.
Uh-huh. But
100% work for fish.
We got fresh fish, we got pretty big fish. We had really hot, short bite windows. We had absolute, like, no hooking fish for many, many hours straight, and we lost our minds a little bit, but we got a 2-hour drive home with some ice cream. So, hope you guys enjoy the video. Be sure to check out Owen's channel if you guys haven't checked him out before. If you look at my channel, we got a bunch of videos in the past. I'm sure we'll have many more in the future. Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. We'll see you in the next one.